The Most Diverse Planet by J.L. Weinmeister. We take the transporter north through the forest. This journey is far shorter, so you get half a day to go off on your adventures. There's a nearby river, and we're right on the edge of the forest and savanna. The options for entertainment are endless. The next day, we travel an equally short distance to a city on the coast. It's in the small section of forest that's truly tropical. The air is sticky with humidity, and the bugs are awful. The people who live in this part of Mersavi are prone to nasty tropical diseases. I caution against spending too much time outside unless you go out onto the ocean. Many of you think that's reason enough to get out in the water, while others use it as an excuse to stay inside and watch performances. That night, I tell you the story of the Vilsnia's creation. Happy with the successful creation of the Elvira, the scientists on Kareena set about brainstorming their next experiment. The Elvira were rather simple in terms of their lifestyle and cultural diversity, so they wanted to create a more complex plan for the next subspecies. It took them many years to work out all the details. They had to shape another planet and make it suitable for habitation. Multiple continents made it more conducive to cultural diversity. The people themselves were fairly similar to the Elvira, though their magic was a little different. Rather than having five powers that have set limitations, Vilsnia can have any combination of four powers. This created a diverse magic set. The scientists decided to create individual cultures for each continent. Mersavi is the largest continent and became the home of the innovators. The scientists wanted to see how more advanced technology would influence society, so they encouraged development on this continent. The continent of Autocris is also large, and it provided a good home for a more capitalist society where merchants and businesses ruled supreme. The scientists were curious to see how an emphasis on commerce affected society. The smallest continent is Tucanara, and it became the home of the most unique culture. The scientists wanted to see what a nomadic, pastoralist society would look like. The lack of mountains and a plethora of grasslands made this continent the perfect place for that experiment. When all three cultures were self-sustaining, the scientists sat back and observed. They were very intrigued by the strengths and weaknesses of each type of society, and they enjoyed watching them change over time. They knew early on that the Vilsnia would face challenges brought on by their lifestyles.